Hi and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be gluing together a two-page layout called 100% Cute. It's a SVG file from Scrapbook Designs, and we'll go ahead and get started. My paper is 12 by 12, and these are cut down to 2.5 inches, the borders. And we'll get started. My photo mats are cut down to, they measure 4 5.5 by 5.5, and they're ready for a 4 inch, or they measure 4.5 by 4.5 and ready for a 4 inch photo to be put in those. And it's for a square photo. And I do square photos because I did a lot. I used to do a lot of 4x6s. And I found personally that I did my layouts. I did a lot of horizontal, but it seemed like all my pictures were vertical. And so I found that by doing a 4x4 layout that I could crop my verticals to fit better. And so I found that doing a 4x4 worked out just as well as doing a 4x6. And actually, yeah, you know, I have more room to do paper piecing and other kinds of embellishments. So that's why I kind of stick to 4x4. Size paper piecing. And this one, I always have flowers. You can call me the flower person because I always like to put flowers in my scrapbooks on the pages. I don't know why, I just like flowers. I live in the 80s when flowers, decorating in your house, were a big thing. I have a hard time getting away from that. I inked my pieces with Powder Puff Evergreen is the color that it's called. And there's the layout, and we'll go ahead and get started. And I use tape glue, dry adhesive for the pictures. I pretty much use liquid glue for everything else. Excuse me, I'm gonna reach in here and grab these little ones. I think I replaced them. And I'm still learning how to make sure to be in the camera. Everything. tried to keep this pretty monochromatic. Into the kind of to the green shades, I guess, except for the paper piecings have a little bit of color in them. And the kind of wet adhesive I'm using today is art glitter glue. I like because it has the precision tip on the end of it, and it glues, it dries pretty quickly. These flowers. Work without the bear. This bear has texture on it, and the parts of the face have texture, and I found that doing the eyes was really hard with texture. That the next time I do this file, I would probably go with smooth the facial of the light colored pieces for the face. I would probably do in a smooth colored, a smooth texture versus this really textured cardstock, just because the eyes didn't turn out near as good as I like them to be. Okay, and that's our first page. It's 100% cute, and it's a file by Scrapping Bug Designs. I'm going to put it over here so I can grab page number 2 and pull it over. We can finish, we can do page number 2. And I'm going to push the stuff off to the side, and I forgot to cut off the very end of it, so excuse me for a minute while I go cut off the very end of it. You can kind of look at these baby bears that are going to go on it, and I will be right back. Paper is from Kaiser Craft, and it's called Peekaboo Lullaby, and it's fairly old. It doesn't have a year on it, but I'm sure that it's at least probably, oh, I would probably guess to say it's at least 13 years old. I'm sure I got this when my first grandchild was born. When I collected scrapbook paper like crazy. again, these are 4x4 photo. Use my art glue to glue. I don't know why, but they always say you should do things in threes. So I usually always do three sets of flowers. there's our page. And I don't think I can get them together. That's too cluttered of an area. I need to make myself a bigger work area, but there's two pages, 100% cute by SVG file by Scrapping Bug Designs, and I need to get myself a bigger work area so that I can lay these out, lay this 12 by 12 page layout so that you can get both pages, a look at both pages at the same time. But there it is, and I hope you like what you saw. If you do, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to the channel. Otherwise, have a great day, and we will talk to you later. Thanks a lot.